welcome. Thank you for coming. We're happy to have you here. This is the Jazzmade. It's the 7th and 8th grade group right now. We are a little bit smaller than we were last year, so what you're hearing right now is a lot of what's called combo music rather than big band music, which if you were listening last year, that's what you heard last year. So what I do for combo music is we find the songs that are 2 to 3 parts, and they share that rather than when we have a big band. There is 5 to 6 saxophones, 5 to 6 trombones, 5 to 6 trumpets, and every single one of them has separate individual parts. So this is just a completely different style of jazz band music that we've gotten to explore this year because of the size. So we were only going to play 3 songs for you, but they really, really argued against me and wanted to play a 4th one that they were working on all season long. I was like, it's a long concert already, guys. Are you sure? And they're like, no, we have to. So you get the privilege of listening to all 4 of the pieces that they worked on, and we hope some of you enjoyed Sesame Street. I know that maybe took some of us back, right? They didn't really know what it was when we gave it to them. Some of them knew. Some of them did, but not all of them, that's for sure. Something that this style of music lends this group to doing is longer, extended solo stuff. And this is really the first year that, this is the first ages that these kids would be having jazz bands, so they're fairly new to this style of music. So when we have solos, they're fairly reserved and they're fairly shy and they're fairly quiet. You hear a lot of the bass clarinet, the clarinet, the trumpet, a little bit of the saxophone, the piano. Like, you hear all of those different solos, and we get the opportunity to extend them out. But the hard part for them, with the exception of one spot that was a saxophone solo in Sesame Street, everything they have to make up on the spot. They get a list of chords that fit what we're doing, and then they make the solo themselves right here in front of you, so that's what you're seeing. Sometimes it goes better than others, you know? Sometimes it's great, and it's never the same. So what you're hearing today that they're soloing is not the same that I've ever heard before, nor was yesterday's or the day before's. Started at the beginning of this year, as most of you know. They have grown exponentially since the last time you've heard them, and especially since the first time you've heard them. So in the very beginning, way back in November-ish when our first concert was, we played out of, it's called a method book, and it's really just a whole bunch of like 8-measure songs to get them to learn how to play together, and they played the exact same notes at the exact same time, the exact same ways. And as we progress through the year with this group, we often try to get them to play multiple parts and layer different things at the same time. So while you're listening to this group, you'll not hear one line being played over and over by the group as a whole. You'll hear different groups within the band playing different sections all at the same time and layering it on itself. And that's kind of a difficult thing to do for 11-year-olds. So this group has actually come really far in that. And they're excited to play their 2 songs for you. Thank you.
working this year in fifth and sixth grade choir. We have many different ways that we are able to create harmony in choirs, just even with a small number. And Shenandoah kind of showcased that a little bit. They started in unison, and then they split into more of a two-part harmony, and then they did more of like a round or a canon type situation, but still achieving that same effect. Our final song is a bit of a Disney medley. It's called Disney Dreams to Share. And so you'll hear some old classic Disney songs mixed with some new Disney songs as well. So enjoy.
A dream is a
band is settling in, and some of the apples didn't fall too far from the tree, right? Yeah? So this band practices every day at 7:55 a.m. So I get them very groggy, very early, sometimes often late, depending on who we're looking at. So getting to hear them in the evening and seeing if they're any different will be fun for all of us. You get to go on this journey with me.
Thank you.
Well, we've got one more song left, See You Again. And I typically like to do songs with 7/8 Choir for May that have to do a little bit with their leadership roles that they've had here. Kind of a nice little send-off idea with Touch the Sky, kind of that going on to that next chapter. So that's typically what I try to accomplish each May during our 7th and 8th grade choir concert. And so we'll end their portion with See You Again.
Is a little crazy because the weather started getting nice and she took a vacation to Alaska, so I mean, I guess to each their own, right? So she's not with us, so we're gonna give them their certificates and pins for the eighth grade. when she returns, we'll likely do that either with their graduation or something like that. So look for those to come home in the next few weeks. So, this band has worked fairly hard on the two pieces that they're going to do for you. If you look at the first one, it's called Palette. This song is a six-movement piece, and each one is fairly short. I know six sounds scary, but they're fairly short. The composer wanted to depict an emotion for each different color and gave like a little bit of teaser of what the emotion might be with the title of the color that you're going to do. So you'll see us play through a quick little piece. They'll pause, sort of regroup, and then do the next one. Something that has often been joked about with this group, and you can decide for yourselves when we're done, is orange. They really like playing orange. I think it's the second one. We've decided that if they play it right, we make a joke about this, that if they play it well, that you'll throw them your car keys of babies. So if the stage is littered with car keys and or babies, that's okay. That means they did good, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, so while they switch over to the last song that we're going to play for you tonight, we do want to say a few things. We want to say thank you for coming. We really appreciate it. We really appreciate your support for all of your students that you give us and allow them to participate in the music here at Holy Redeemer. We hope to see them grow. That being said, this is a wonderful 8th grade class to have worked with. I am very happy with their growth, with their personalities, with just them as people. They are wonderful people. So be proud as parents that you raised good children. The next song that we're playing, it's called Fragile. Fragile is, it's part of a much larger, it's called a masterwork. There are like 5 or 6 pieces to this masterwork, and this is the lowest level one. So this is like the first one that comes in, and this masterwork was written by a living composer out of Missouri. He struggled most of his young adult life and teenage years being bullied and with a lot of mental health issues. And it goes into this in the program notes that is sent with it. And so this song is about mental illness, and the whole masterwork is about mental illness and how to overcome or grow out of it, or sometimes some people don't make it out. This is just one of the, I think, 7 or 8 very long movements. This is one of the shortest ones. So while I don't see too many car keys up here yet, we still have a chance. I'd rather the keys.